Well, it's finally happened. My cat evolved. He wants me to call him Steve. Can you believe that? Steve is obsessed with vinyl and coffee shops. He wants me to take him to the best burrito in the city. Did I say evolved? Hey there, evolved primate animals of the family great ape. Trace here. You're watching a science show, so I'm assuming you know what evolution is. Slow change over time by random mutation, right? It usually takes generations to observe evolution in action. As Darwin wrote in On the Origin of Species, natura non facit saltum. Nature makes no leap. But perhaps Darwin was looking in the wrong place, and in cities, natura salit. Nature jumps. Normally in natural and non-urban systems, evolution takes about 1 million years. But in urban systems, evolution might work completely differently. From 2000 to 2030, human cities will nearly triple in land area, adding another 1.2 million square kilometers, or about the whole of South Africa, to urbanization. This will obviously affect the evolution of animals that we share this planet with. And a new study in the January 2017 Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences has found just that. Rapid human urbanization screws with the evolution of species, causing evolution to happen not in a million years, but sometimes just in a few decades. As humans build cities, we displace and severely alter the natural environment, causing animals to adapt, slash mutate, or go extinct. Say we cut down a forest and put up buildings over a few years. Without the forest, migratory birds have to adapt to be able to stop and rest in this new environment. And that might seem easy, but birds don't think that buildings and trees are similar. Buildings might not provide the cover from predators birds evolved to seek out. Buildings don't have tasty bugs living on or near them that birds might eat, so they might just fly on by. But birds with mutations, enabling them to adapt to these new conditions, they might go on to survive. And the others don't. Evolution by human natural selection. This is similar to the idea of human harvesting or human selection. We take an animal out of the natural order and guide its evolution in a favorable way to us. Think farm animals or pets. And the built environment isn't just about sidewalks and buildings. Transmission towers for cell phones and radio are often made of zinc-coated steel, because zinc doesn't rust. But zinc can be toxic to some plants, causing necrotic lesions and chlorosis, which is a reduction of green color. Plants with mutations to resist zinc can thrive on or near towers, while others may die out. Again, evolution by human selection. Even when we try and help by, say, building fish ladders to provide a path for spawning species like we did in 1966 at a dam in Norway, human activities still affect natural evolution. By 2003, the brown trout that were too large or too small to use that Norwegian fish ladder had pretty much died out, leaving only the middle-sized mutants behind. Who cares, am I right? Well, lots of other species rely on the trout, either to eat or to be eaten. Different trout can change the whole ecosystem. Just like with the bird and plant examples, we have no idea the ultimate cost or benefit to these human-selected mutations thanks to our urbanization. Of course, urbanization has been connected to global warming as well, but we also have to consider things like overfishing, overhunting, land use, habitat destruction, and of course, human harvesting of animals from an environment. All of these things have an effect on evolution. There was a time when humans could stand in a desert and know that we are but a speck on a speck. The power of the Earth is the ultimate authority, and that's still true, of course, but now the Earth has a middle manager, and we are really changing how things work around here. Maybe not always in the best way. How does this make you feel? Let us know down in the comments. Can evolution reverse? Can we make it better? Watch this video to find out. And please subscribe so you get more D News.